Hello everyone. Thank you for stopping by my channel, Get Crafty with Sally. My name is Sally Poole. I am a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator in Albany, Oregon. Welcome. I appreciate you stopping by. Today I'm going to show you how to make this. Well, it's a variation of this card. I'm not going to add the gold layer. This is called Layers of Beauty, and it is a fabulous new product in the catalog, which is coming out. Well, the catalog is out, but you'll be able to order next month in about a little over a week if you're not a demonstrator. There is a bundle. It's on page 57 in here, and it includes the Layers of Beauty stamp set, the dies. This is the big die. I've already taken it out of the package. And then there's also the Layers of Beauty decorative masks, which make it really easy to color these beautiful floral images. There are 5 masks in the set. Stampin' Up! Seems to be making them a little more detailed and intricate, which I really like. So let's show you what you need to make this. These are the pieces of cardstock that you're going to need. As always, I will have a PDF with all of the measurements and the supplies that I've used. So you can either take a screenshot of this, or you can go over to my blog and get the PDF. There is a link down below this video in the description box to my blog where the PDF is. So today I have got a glass mat, not a Stampin' Up! Glass mat. I don't have that one yet. I already had a couple other companies. And I'm also using a sticky mat, a grip mat. I don't know if you're familiar with these. They are great for stenciling masks. This is from Waffle Flower. They have some different sizes. I have the 6.5 by 8.5. It does come with little templates to line things up, so it's great. I don't know if you can see the actual mat, but it's, I don't know, maybe 3/8 of an inch thick, and it's, I believe it's photopolymer. It is sticky. So you can just take your cardstock and just stick it right down to this mat, and it will hold it. And I'm also going to apply the masks over this, and they will also stick. You don't have to have one of these sticky mats to do this process. You can just lay your cardstock down, your stamped image, and then you can just lay your masks over the top of it, and you can either hold them or you can put some tape down to hold them. If I was doing it without the sticky mat, I think I would put a little bit of gosh, I can't think of what it's called, repositionable tape, the tape that comes off, that's not permanent, on the back here, a couple little spots just to hold this still, and then I would place my masks down and tape them so the whole thing holds still and you don't have to hold it. So let me, this is number 1. They are all numbered like the other sets that we have. So I'm just going to line this up, and it's actually pretty easy to line it up. And I'll give this a press onto the grip mat, and it's going to hold that down in place. So this one I stamped in Memento Tuxedo Black ink. This one I actually stamped in Versamark and then heat embossed it in gold. So it's more along the fancy line. That's why I'm not using the gold on the back. No embossing today. So let me grab my chair and we'll get started with this process. Let me see if there's anything else that I should tell you at this point. The colors that I'm going to use, and I've made several of these cards already, and I just keep grabbing colors and giving them a try. I have Flirty Flamingo, Peach Pie, Old Olive, Granny Apple Green, and Petunia Pop. And this is Flirty Flamingo. So let's grab our Flirty Flamingo. Open that up, and we'll grab a blending brush. And I'm going to get some ink on my blending brush. Hopefully you can see that. I better check. Hopefully that is in the camera. You can either wipe a little bit of it off on a piece of paper or write on the mask, because you can always pick it up again. And I'm going to do these three larger flowers in Flirty Flamingo. And I'm just, for this first mask, because there's three for these flowers, I'm going to go in pretty light. And I'm just going to swirl this brush around a little bit. Try to stay out of that little flower there. And you can do as light as you want or as dark as you want, but you are going to want three shades of this color. I do have examples of other cards that I have used different colors for these flowers, not just three layers of the same. Okay, so I'm going to leave that open. Now I'm going to grab, let's see, I think I want my, these little flowers, I think, just to be different, I'm going to make them with Petunia Pop. So I'm going to grab a purple blending brush. And see, that's a pretty saturated color, so you want to be careful with it. I believe that for these little flowers, there are two different layers to them. And then the third mask is for the centers of the flowers. So keep that in mind. So, and we're going to do two layers of this one also on those flowers. So that is mask one. So let's pull that off, see what we've got. I do think I want my Flirty Flamingo a little bit darker. And I'm not trying to get the whole flower colored in the same tone. You can try to make some little darker areas if you want. Leave some of it lighter. Okay, so let's pull this off. See how nice that stuck down? And let's grab mask number 2. It's gonna do the next layer of the flowers. So we'll line this up. That looks good. Give that a press. I've got all these papers around here so you don't see the reflection of my ring light. And that's another story. I turned my ring light on this morning and nothing. There was nothing. And I think I've probably had it maybe a year. So here's our second layer of Flirty Flamingo. So I'm going to give that a little more pressure than I did the first time. And remember, you don't need to make it all smooth and the same color. So anyway, I turned my ring light on this morning and nothing. So I turned the little knob and it makes the light brighter, dimmer. And finally turned it up as far as it goes, which I don't think I've ever used it on that setting. And it kind of did a little click. So that's where I'm at. It's either on bright or it's off. There's no in between today. So here's my second layer of Petunia Pop. This is one of the new ink colors and I love it. So we'll put a little second layer on these small flowers. This is a really fun process, and once you do one, you will find that it goes by pretty quickly. So let me take a peek and see what my second layer of Flirty looks like, and I think that looks pretty good. So we'll pull that mask off, bring in our third mask. This is more of a detailed part of the flowers. So this one you can line up on the center of these little flowers. That seems to work best. So that looks good. We'll give that a press. And I'm not going to use my Petunia Pop again, so I can put that one away, put my brush away, and I'm going to grab my Flirty Flamingo again. I'm going to give this a pretty good little press this time. Let's see how that looks. It's nice that you can pick this up and put it right back down where it was. I'll put a little bit more there. And then I think for the center of the small flowers, I'm going to use the new Peach Pie. Grab a different brush. Is way more of a yellow than the Flirty Flamingo. And remember, when you get this ink on here, you can actually pick it up and finish using it. Okay, so we're done with that color. Now, masks 4 and 5 to the leaves. So we'll put that brush away. And I'm going to grab mask number 4. Line it up. When I did the heat embossed, well, I have one that's heat embossed in white. It was kind of hard to see on here and line up, but it is doable. And I think that might be my favorite card. I'll show you the other examples in a few minutes. So this is Granny Apple Green, and I'm gonna put it on kind of lightly. So it just depends on your taste, what you're going for, and how vivid you want these colors. So that's a good layer of the Granny Apple Green. And I am going to take the same color, Granny Apple Green, and I'm going to try to do the bottom of some of these larger leaves and make them a little bit darker. I think it just adds a little bit of depth and interest. Okay, so the next color I'm going to use, the last color, is Old Olive. So we'll take this mask off. See how nice that's coming out? And it's so easy. Don't want to stick my hand in that. Okay, this is our number 5 mask. I'm lining it up with the same leaves. It's just gonna give a little definition, darker definition to the center of the leaves, like the third mask on the flower did, where I made it darker with the Flirty Flamingo. So we'll go over all of these spots. The dogs just came in from the backyard and have grabbed some toys, so hopefully it won't get crazy in here. All right, let's take a peek at this. All right, I think that looks good. So let me put my Old Olive ink away. And now I'm gonna stand up. Let's pull this off of here. You can take a closer look at it. You can see the different layers of color. Isn't that nice? It's so fun. And I'm going to take this now and move it out of the way because I don't need it anymore. And now I'm going to go cut this out. So I've just got some post-it note tape. It is 1 inch wide. These seem to last pretty good. I'm trying to line this up without sticking my head in front of the camera. So we'll tape that down there. Better grab another piece just to make sure. Just Still got that lined up. Tape that down. Let me run over to my cut and emboss machine and cut this out, and I'll be right back. Okay, so there is our cutout piece. Isn't that fun? And the die is great. My thought on doing this and cutting it out is they look better. Of course, this has a white background because I did it on basic white paper. I think they look better on when you have a white layer behind it. Then it kind of hides all of that white paper that's in here. So let's start putting our card together. I've got my, that's got a little piece sticking out on it. Cut that off. A little fuzzy thing. So this is Granny Apple Green for this card and basic white, and I have used the exposed brick folder this time. I have a whole stack of folders that I've used for all of the cards that I've made, so I'll put all of that in the PDF as well. So I'm going to, let me grab a piece of scrap paper so I can see what I'm doing. I think I'll just put tape on the back of this. I couldn't find, I wanted to use that little, the embossing folder that has the little flowers. This one. But I can't find it. It must be in one of my stacks of paper somewhere. So I have no idea what that one looks like. So let's try to get this down even. It's a little torn piece up at the very top. I don't think anybody will ever notice it. So we will put this down on our card base. I tried the Flirty Flamingo paper as a background for this, but I just didn't think that it looked that great. So I'm going to sit down again. Excuse me. And I've already stamped my sentiment. I'm using Sending Hugs. I don't remember which set it's from, but I will have all of that in my PDF. Here's a brand new extra large giant bottle of green glue. And I've cut the sentiment out with, for this one, with my rectangle stitch dies, and then just made a really narrow border with the Granny Apple Green. So I'm going to take my die cut piece And I'm going to put some dimensionals on the back. Which is quite a few. Probably not totally necessary, but it's kind of what I do. Let me see if I have, let's just grab some mini ones, put them on these little pieces that are hanging out. All right, I think I'm gonna grab a few of these little half guys. And don't forget to use all of the dimensional. Don't just pick your dimensionals up off and use them and then throw the rest of the pack away. It's all the same stuff. It's all sticky. So use it all. A lot of times I cut around the edge to use little straight pieces. All right, that's probably plenty. So now I have to pull all these covers off. And when I was putting these die cut pieces on the card base, I really had a hard time deciding which position I wanted them to go. And on the stamp set, they've got it so it's kind of laying, I'm going to call it, on its back. I didn't do any cards with it that way. I couldn't get it to look good for some reason. So I do kind of have things turned around different ways on different cards. But this is what we're going to do for this card, because I do want a little spot for a sentiment. You could put Wink Estella on here if you wanted. Some of mine I sprayed with my alcohol and champagne mist mix. I'll put a link to this also in the description box. So let's glue our sentiment down. Not even squeezing this glue bottle, and the glue is coming out. Okay, so let's put our sending hugs right up here. Make sure I'm getting it straight. And then I'm going to add a few of the iridescent pearls, basic jewels. And I think that I will just use small ones. And then, of course, you would put a piece of white cardstock inside so that you can write on it. You could put the Granny Apple Green border around it if you wanted. I have got dimensional covers everywhere. Okay, so that is that card. What do you think of it? I am having so much fun with this set. I really love it. So there is the gold embossed card, Flirty Flamingo. And this one, let's see. I believe I used Berry Burst for this. And then I used some of my crinkled seam binding ribbon, colored the pearls with bubble bath, dark bubble bath. This one is Sweet Sorbet. And then I've got little embellishments on here that are not Stampin' Up. I can't remember what company I got them from, but they look like little water drops to me. I think they're so sweet. This one I did with the Petunia Pop. And the paper on the background of this one is from this Thoughtful Designs specialty paper. It's kind of, I can't think of the word. The one sheet of paper changes color from like yellowy green to a darker green, or purpley to blue. It's very pretty. Here's another one with Flirty Flamingo and that paper out of that pack. And this one is I used Peach Pie on the first two layers of the flowers, and then I used Pumpkin Pie for the third mask. I think that's pretty. And then this, I don't know if you can see this or not. I've popped up. I did an extra flower here, and there's a die that cuts this out, and I popped it up. So this little die right here cuts that flower out. And then here's another way you can use it. You don't have to use the entire mask. So this one I did not cut out. This one is just stamped on the basic white paper. And then I stamped directly on the paper as well. So this one's pretty easy. And this one, I think, is my favorite. It is, I know it looks pink, but it is actually Berry Burst. This is the one that I heat embossed in white that was kind of hard to see to get the mask in the right spot. But I just think it turned out so sweet and dainty and pretty. I think that is my favorite. I will be doing a giveaway. So if you leave a comment down below, say anything you want, as long as it's nice. Let's play nice. Let's say in 3 weeks, the middle of May, I will draw a name and then mail you one of these cards. So make sure you leave a comment, do all the good things like thumbs up, comments, share the video with your friends and family, and subscribe to my channel. That would really be great. It helps me grow and keeps me going. So I hope you're having a good day. Again, I thank you for stopping by and spending some time with me. Those of you that are floral stamp lovers, I think that you're going to want this bundle. So also, if you have any questions, you can also put them down in the comments. I will look down there for questions. So have a great rest of your day, and I will see you next time. Thanks.